Today we're looking at the 1967 Kennedy half dollar coin and what can make these coins valuable. So if you inherited a coin collection or maybe you are just now getting into coins and you have any half dollar coins, definitely watch this whole video because there are a ton of different things that you can look for on these coins that can give them some value. And this also applies, some of these things apply to other Kennedy half dollar coins as well, not just the 1967. So welcome back to Couch Collectibles. Hope you guys are having an awesome day as always. If you guys are new, feel free to check out all the other videos here on the channel. We're uploading videos every single day. As always, let's just hop into this one. All right, starting off first with the 1967 Kennedy half dollar coin. Of course, these are going to be 40% silver for the year 1967. So of course, if you have a 1967 regular Kennedy half dollar, it's always going to be worth more than 50 cents. Because it has silver value, but it also has numismatic value as well. And in this case, it has some more value because it is a mint error. So we'll see that large clip there on the right side of the coin, a 10% ragged clip. That will give the coin some value. This half dollar ended up selling for over $60. Now this next coin here has triple curved clips. So you'll see three of them, one on each side of the coin and one at the bottom below the date. This coin ended up selling for over $125. It is graded at an AU58. The coin grading scale goes up to 70. 70 is the best condition you can get. This is at a 58, graded by NGC. Now this next coin here is graded by PCGS at a Mint State 64. And this coin is in, you know, pretty good condition, Mint State 64. However, it has a double die obverse. So that is going to give it some value. So there's doubling taking place on the front of this Kennedy half dollar coin. So where do you want to look for that? You want to look for that on the lettering. So look for that on the front of the coin, on the lettering, the word Liberty, as well as the phrase "In God We Trust." You can see that doubling there as well. So this half dollar coin, because of its condition and that doubling, sold for $2,000. So make sure you guys look for that doubling with your coin microscopes that are available on couchcollectibles.com. So here's a 1967 Kennedy half dollar coin that has a double die reverse. So not doubling on the front of the coin, but doubling on the back of the coin, the reverse. Now it is graded at a MS65, Mint State 65 there. So a very good grade for a coin like this. Here's the doubling that you want to look for most noticeably there on the stars. So always be on the lookout for that 1967 double die reverse on the stars. This coin sold for over $640. Here's a 1967 half dollar that has been struck on a defective planchet graded by NGC. You'll see that worn down there on both sides of the coin, the obverse and reverse. This coin sold for over $160, graded at a Mint State 62. So of course the grade matters as well. Now this next coin sold for over $4,000, graded by PCGS at a Mint State 67+. And that's where all of the value is at in the coin, is the grade, the condition. It is in an older PCGS slab. So this coin does not have any errors. It's valuable because of its condition. There's probably not many of these out there at a 67+. That's what gives the coin its value. Now this next coin here has a clamshell lamination taking place here, graded by NGC at an AU58. The coin sold for a little over $45, so nothing too valuable there. You know, had it been a Mint State grade, it could have sold for a little more. Now here is a 1967 where the obverse is misaligned, so a misaligned die there. You'll see that there most noticeably at the bottom and to the left of the bottom of the coin. Graded at a AU58, this coin sold for around $75. This next coin sold for over $800. It is the 1967 SMS Special Mint Set Kennedy half dollar coin that was struck onto a 25 cent planchet. 25 cent planchet. Kennedy half dollar design struck onto a quarter planchet. Awesome, amazing coin here, sold for $840. Now on the SMS, Kennedy half dollar coins from 1967, you want to look for a quadruple die obverse. So you'll see that there on the lettering, you'll see that there at the bottom of the T, you can see that quadrupled. Very, very nice mint error there. That is awesome. So here is a 1967 SMS graded at a Mint State 69 Ultra Cameo, and this coin sold for $31,000 because of it being an SMS and because of that extremely high grade. Graded at a 69, 70 is the highest you can get. Here's another SMS 1967 half dollar where the obverse has been struck through. So we'll see that there on the front of the coin. Graded by NGC at a Mint State 65. This coin only sold for a little over $40. So, not really worth having that one graded because, you know, you're not really getting much out of it. You're probably going to pay more to have it graded than you will sell for. So here is a 1967 that has a strike through here on the reverse of the coin. Looks very normal on the obverse. Graded by PCGS at an AU58. And this coin ended up selling for a little over $100. Now this next coin is kind of opposite in a way. It's struck through here on the obverse, not the reverse. Partially through the clay layer. So this coin is graded at a Mint State 64 by NGC. And this coin sold for $150. Moving right along to a 1967 half dollar that was struck onto a thin planchet. Only weighs 9.5 grams as a result. Unfortunately, the coin has been cleaned, so do not clean your coins because that will take away from the value of them. This coin did sell for a little over 40 bucks. Had it not been cleaned, it could have sold for more. Now here's a 1967 half dollar that was struck onto a thin planchet again, weighing 9 grams this time, graded at an AU58. This coin ended up selling for around $100. All right, can't beat that, 100 bucks for 50 cents. Alright guys, don't forget to subscribe in the middle, check out the videos to the left of me, and until tomorrow, I'll see you guys in the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.